Hey everyone, Intel's next generation processors are launching real soon, and motherboard manufacturers have taken this opportunity to refresh their lineup of LGA 1700 motherboard offerings. With that in mind, for today's video, we'll be taking a look at a new Intel Z790 motherboard offering from MSI, the MAG Z790 Tomahawk Max Wi-Fi. Let's get started. As an offering from the MAG series of products, this board is positioned more at the mid-range of MSI's Z790 motherboard offerings, sitting below the performance-oriented MPG series of products and the top-of-the-line MEG series of enthusiast-class product offerings. As you can see, the MAG Z790 Tomahawk Max Wi-Fi comes in a predominantly black box with green accents, and moving over to the rear, we get the usual overview of specs for this board. We'll run through these specs in detail later on in this video. On a side note, if you're new to the ALKtech channel, do consider subscribing so as to keep up to date with the latest developments in the PC hardware world. With that, let's get on with it. In terms of accessories, MSI's included a Wi-Fi antenna right here. With that, let's set aside the board for now to have a look at the rest of the accessories that this board comes with. First up, we get two SATA 3 cables. And these are accompanied by two spare easy M.2 clips that facilitate the toolless installation and removal of your M.2 drives. We do also get a front panel header extension cable that makes connecting the front panel headers of this board to your PC case a breeze. A thumb drive containing drivers and utilities. A quick start guide right here. A regulatory information leaflet. A marketing leaflet encouraging owners of this board to leave a product review, as well as a sheet of MSI stickers. And with that, here it is, the MSI MAG Z790 Tomahawk Max Wi-Fi. We see that MSI has gone for a relatively uncontroversial aesthetic with a black-coloured PCB and large black heat sinks all around that feature lime green accents for a nice pop of colour. Fans of RGB lighting effects might be disappointed to note that the board does not come with any onboard RGB LEDs, though it does of course come with an assortment of RGB headers, which I'll cover later on in this video. The board comes with an integrated I/O shield design with decently sized VRM heatsinks. In terms of VRM specs, MSI has included 16+1+1 power phases with 90 amp power stages. The board comes with a large passive heatsink for the Z790 chipset and for M.2 drive cooling. MSI's included heatsinks for all four M.2 drive slots that this board comes with the third and fourth M.2 slots sharing a common heatsink. The rear of the motherboard is quite a standard affair, though we do get some markings that MSI calls case standoff keepout zones to serve as a warning not to install unneeded motherboard standoffs within your PC case, which could otherwise short-circuit the board. MSI has also taken the liberty to include protective paint around the motherboard's screw holes so as to protect the PCB against scratches, which is a nice touch. For memory support, the MAG Z790 Tomahawk Max Wi-Fi comes with 4 DDR5 slots with support for up to 192GB of RAM and the DDR5 7800 Plus standard when overclocked, with plastic slots of a dual tab design. Near the bottom of the RAM slots is a USB 3.2 Gen 1 front panel header that provides support for up to 2 USB 3.2 Gen 1 Type-A ports, and further down, a USB 3.2 Gen 2 Type-C front panel header. While still on the topic of front panel USB connectivity, the bottom edge of the board houses two USB 2.0 front panel headers right here, with each header providing support for up to two USB 2.0 Type-A ports. Moving on to some of the special features that this board comes with, we get a USB 4 expansion card header that is to be hooked up to an optional USB 4 PCIe expansion card that supports up to 100 watts of power delivery and is sold separately by MSI. We do also get a safe boot header that allows end users to boot with default BIOS settings while lowering the CPU's PCIe operation mode, which I guess is a great feature to have on hand for overclocking purposes. Moving back up top, we get a set of easy debug LEDs that can help with troubleshooting power on self-test issues. In terms of expansion slots, this board comes with a PCIe 5.0 x16 slot for a graphics card. The said slot comes with the steel armor feature that reinforces the slot for use with heavy graphics cards. We also get a PCIe 3.0 x1 slot as well as a PCIe 4.0 x16 slot that operates at x4 mode. In the storage department, MSI has included 8 SATA 3 ports, with 6 ports in a right-angled configuration so as to aid with cable management, and 2 ports in a straight-angled configuration. Moving on to M.2 slots, the board comes with 4 M.2 slots, of which this first slot here supports the PCIe 5.0 X4 standard, while the remaining 3 slots support the PCIe 4.0 X4 standard, of which this third slot here, slot M2_3, also supports M.2 SATA drives. Do note that as the Intel Z790 chipset does not have dedicated PCIe 5.0 lanes for M.2 drives, what MSI has done is that it has split the PCIe 5.0 x16 lanes for a graphics card into half, such that if you have a M.2 drive installed in this M2_1 slot, the primary PCIe 5.0 x16 slot for a graphics card will drop down to operate at PCIe 5.0 x8 mode instead. Also, do note that if you have a M.2 drive installed in this M2_3 slot, SATA ports 1 and 2 will be disabled. For audio, MSI's gone for a premium Realtek ALC4080 audio codec, while wired internet connectivity is courtesy of Intel's i225V, which provides support for 2.5 gigabit Ethernet. The board's Wi-Fi is powered by a Qualcomm QCNCM865 module that supports the latest Wi-Fi 7 standard and Bluetooth 5.4 as well. In the cooling and RGB departments, the board comes with a whopping 8 fan headers that are located in these regions of the board. Also included are 3 addressable RGB headers and a 12-volt standard RGB header located right here. Moving over to the rear I/O, the MAG Z790 Tomahawk Max Wi-Fi goes for an integrated I/O shield design. The board comes with a DisplayPort 1.4 connector that supports display output of up to 8K resolution at 60Hz, a HDMI 2.1 port that supports display output of up to 4K resolution at 60Hz, 4 USB 3.2 Gen 1 Type-A ports, a clear CMOS button, a flash BIOS button that allows you to update the board's BIOS without needing a CPU, RAM or graphics card installed, 4 USB 3.2 Gen 2 Type-A ports, of which this port here supports the flash BIOS feature, a USB 3.2 Gen 2 Type-C port, a 2.5 gigabit Ethernet port, a USB 3.2 Gen 2x2 Type-C port, Wi-Fi antenna connectors, as well as your usual audio jack connectors. In conclusion, the MSI MAG Z790 Tomahawk Max Wi-Fi looks to be an Intel Z790 motherboard offering with a well-balanced feature set, in my opinion. where it serves up a beefy VRM setup, PCIe 5.0 support for a graphics card, a high-end audio codec, and support for the latest Wi-Fi 7 standard. That said, I'm unfortunately not a fan of the PCIe lane arrangement for this board, where you do lose PCIe bandwidth for your graphics card if you do have a drive installed in the PCIe 5.0 M.2 slot that this board comes with. With that, thank you so much for watching, hit the like button and get subscribed if you've enjoyed this video, and I'll catch you guys around the next time.